بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is Allah's true slave and messenger. May Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam be upon the noble prophet and the believers of his family and the noble companions and those who follow on their path until the day of resurrection. Now, the second matter concerning the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is this. Are they limited to a certain number? Are the names of Allah limited to a certain number? Or they are limitless? The answer. Some people of knowledge are with the opinion that they are limited to 99 names. Some are with the opinion that they are limited to 99 names. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is witr. Witr meaning quote unquote odd. And because the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, Inna lillahi 99 asma, man ahsaha dakhala al-jannah. To Allah belongs 99 names, whoever ahsaha, and we have to put this in Arabic now, because what does it mean? Ahsaha. Literally it would mean whoever enumerates them will enter paradise. This is an opinion. Some of the scholars, on the other hand, said that the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not limited to a certain number. And they took evidence from the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him. And it's an authentic hadith. The hadith of sorrow and hardship, when the person is touched by that. If the person is touched by grief or sorrow, he invokes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in that hadith of invocation, referring to this state, أَسْأَلُكَ بِكُلِّ اسْمٍ هُوَ لَكَ. O Allah, I ask you, by every name of yours, سَمَّيْتَ بِهِ نَفْسَكَ, you named himself, you named yourself with, أَوْ أَنْزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ, or you revealed in your book, أَوْ عَلَّمْتَهُ أَحَدًا مِّنْ خَلْقِكَ, or that you taught, made it known to any of your creation, أَوْ اسْتَأْثَرْتَ بِهِ فِي عِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ عِنْدَكَ, or you have kept with you in the knowledge of the unseen with you. The point of evidence from this hadith is the saying of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, أَوْ اسْتَأْثَرْتَ بِهِ فِي عِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ عِنْدَكَ, the last statement, or that you have kept with you in the world of the unseen. Because what Allah had kept with him in this world, لا يمكن إدراكه, cannot be known. And thus, it cannot be limited to 99 names. And this opinion, this saying is the correct opinion, is the preponderating one, that the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are not limited, and not all of them are known to us, because of this statement in the hadith. Now, there remains the need to answer the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, that to Allah belongs 99 names, whoever ahsaha, enumerates them, enters paradise. How is the answer concerning this statement by the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام? We say that to Allah belongs 99 names, موصوفة بأن من أحصاها دخل الجنة, described as whoever enumerates them enters paradise, meaning ويعني, and this in itself means, وهناك أسماء أخرى لا علاقة لها بهذا الحكم, and that there are other names which have no relation to this ruling. Like, for example, you say, I have 100 horses which I have prepared for jihad. in the cause of Allah. Does this mean that you don't have other than these 100? If we know that you have 1,000, the answer is no. And the hadith is something similar to this. أن المعنى that the 99 names are described that من أحصاها دخل الجنة, and this means that there are other names which has not related to this. So the meaning would be from the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, therefore there are 99 names, whoever enumerates them enters paradise. And in this case, the numbers, their number is not restricted or limited. There remains still another question. هل هذه التسعة والتسعون هل يمكن الإحاطة بها علما؟ Are these 99 names? Is it possible regarding these 99 names that one can comprehend them in knowledge? الجواب yes. The answer is yes. Because had it not been the case, then the wording of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام لكان لغوة, it would have been in vain talk. So what is the method therefore to enumerate them? The answer. This came in one hadith which enumerated these names. However, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah cautioned that the sard of these names is mudraj, that the enumeration is the saying of the narrator, and it is not وليس من كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فلا يحتج به. However, it is not from the wordings of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and therefore it cannot be used as a proof. And he cited, for example, that from the names which are not mentioned in this hadith reported by Tirmidhi is the name Ar-Rabb. And we know that Ar-Rabb is one of the names of Allah, and it is not mentioned in these enumerated in that hadith. And Ar-Rabb is one of the names of Allah. We read in the hadith, As-siwaku mutharatun lil-fammi mardatun lil-rabbi. The siwak, the wooden toothbrush from the Arak tree, is a purification for the mouth, mardatun lil-rabb, a pleasure to Ar-Rabb, to the Lord. So this is one name. It is not mentioned in this hadith. Also, the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ said regarding the ruku' in salah, أَمَّا الرُّكُوعُ فَعَظِّمُ فِيهِ الرَّبِّ. In ruku', in bowing, magnify Ar-Rabb. Magnify Ar-Rabb, magnify the Lord. Also from his name is Ash-Shafi, the one who heals. And it is not mentioned in this enumerated in this hadith. It was from the Ruqya, the recitation of the Prophet ﷺ on the sick person to say, Washfi anta Ash-Shafi. O Allah, bring the cure, and you are the one who cures. So then the question still holds. What is the path to enumerate them? The path is to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make them completely known, as he did with Laylatul Qadr, as he did with the night of decree, and as he did also with respect to the hour where he responds to the invocation on Friday. Why? من أجل أن يكون لنا عمل في تتبع هذه الأسماء وحصرها. So that we exert the effort to search for these names and enumerate them, and in this way the one who is keen will get reward and he will be distinguished from the one who is not. And therefore also we say هذا القرآن, this is the Quran, and this is the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Follow the Quran, search, تتبع السنة, search, take from the Quran and from the Sunnah 99 names, enumerate, then you will enter paradise. However, there still remains, what does it mean to enumerate أحصاها, what does it mean? Does it really mean the translation which you have heard, meaning enumerate them in number, or this ihsa is something else? If you want to know what is intended, then examine the recompense. Examine the reward. What is the reward? دخول الجنة. دخول الجنة. Entering paradise. Mere enumeration, mere calculation or finding the number, enumeration, is not on its own stand to be a recompense to enter paradise. So therefore, المراد بالإحصاء, what is intended by إحصاء is knowing the names by their texts, by their words, and knowing the meaning, and dua Allah biha, and invoking Allah by these names, والتعبد له بمقتضاها, and to worship him in that which these names entail. I will repeat. Therefore, the ihsa of Allah's names that came in the hadith means know their words, the text, the meaning, invoking Allah by them, and worship Allah through what these names entail. For example, if you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ghafoor, oft forgiving, it is not enough in this ihsa to know that al-ghafoor is one of the names of Allah. This is one thing, but it is not enough. And that the meaning is the one who covers the sins and pardons them, this is not enough until you invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by his name, and therefore you say Ya Ghafoor Ighfir Li, O Allah the forgiving, forgive me, wa hatta tata'abbada lillahi bimuqtada, and until you worship Allah by what this name entails, بأن تتعرض لمغفرة الله بكثرة الاستغفار وكثرة الأعمال الصالحة التي توجب المغفرة, such that you exert yourself with abundant istighfar, seeking forgiveness, and abundant righteous deeds, all of which would entail forgiveness. This is the meaning of Ihsa. This is the meaning of Ihsa. The third matter. Is this clear now, inshallah? Is this clear now, the meaning of Ihsa? Those who understood it, please put one. Okay, is the meaning of Ihsa clear to you? Tayyib, alhamdulillah. Now, the third matter. هل أسماء الله عز وجل توقيفية يقتصر فيها على ما جاء به النص؟ Are the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restricted to the textual reference? Or أو هي عقلية فيسمى الله عز وجل بما يقتضيه العقل or are they intellectual so Allah is to be named in accordance to what the intellect may entail the answer هي توقيفية The names are restricted, meaning to the texts, because we don't know. لأننا لا نعلم الاسم الذي يستحق أن يسمى الله به. We don't know the name by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deserves to be named with. عقولنا تقصر عن ذلك. Our intellect fall short from this. And therefore we depend upon the text. وَلَا يُسَمَّ اللَّهُ بِمَا لَمْ يُسَمِّ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ And thus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not to be named by other than that which He named Himself with. And if it is the case that with respect to the children of Adam, you don't name someone with that name which he didn't name himself with. Therefore, what about Allah Azza wa Jal? It is by all means more fitting that we don't name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by other than that which he named himself with. Because لأن جانب الربوبية أعظم احتراما من جانب البشرية. Because Allah's Lordship is greater than the respect for the human nature, a created one. And accordingly, فَالْأَسْمَاءُ تَوْقِيفِيَّ Accordingly, the names of Allah are restrictive or restricted to the text. And therefore, it is not allowable or permissible to name Allah by that which He didn't name Himself with. And this is from the deviation concerning the names of Allah to name Him by other than what He named Himself. Now, if we say that, and this is the truth, that the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are husna, most beautiful, most perfect. And if we apply this now to the hadith al-Qudsi, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says يؤذين ابن آدم يسب الدهر وأنا الدهر بيدي الأمر أقلب الليل والنهار The son of Adam hurts me for he abuses الدهر abuses time though I am time All matters are in my hands, and I cause the revolution of day and night. So Allah said here, وَأَنَا الدَّهْرُ And I am time. فَهَلِ الدَّهْرُ مِنْ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ Is therefore a dahr, time from the names of Allah? الجواب, the answer. We say that Allah said about His names, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى And to Allah belongs the best of names. So, Allah qualified his names that they are best. Husna. وَالدَّهْرُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَسْمَاءِ اللَّهِ الْحُسْنَى. And at time, الدَّهْر is not from his best names. Because ثُمَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَالْ. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يُؤْذِينِ ابْنُ آدَمْ يَسُبُّ الدَّهْر. The son of Adam hurts me, for he abuses time. وَالَّذِينَ يَسُبُّونَ الدَّهْر لَيْسُوا يَسُبُّونَ اللَّهِ بَلْ يَسُبُّونَ الْوَقْتِ يَسُبُّونَ الزَّمَنْ يَسُبُّونَ السَّنَةِ لَيْسُوا يَسُبُّونَ اللَّهِ. And those who curse the time, they don't curse Allah, rather they curse the time, they curse the year, they are not cursing Allah. And therefore the meaning of Allah saying in the hadith, وَأَنَا الدَّهْر, and I am time, meaning I am the creator of time, أَنَا الْمُدَبِّرُ وَالْمُتَصَرِّفُ فِي الدَّهْر. I am the creator of time, and I am the one who runs the affairs of everything that takes place in time. This is evident in the last statement in the hadith, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the hadith al-Qudsi, بيدي الأمر أقلب الليل والنهار. In my hands, all matters are in my hands, and I cause the revolution of day and night. And this is now a clear matter that الدهر هنا هو الوقت. That الدهر here means the time, and that it is not a name of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We stop here, inshallah ta'ala. We will go to the fourth matter tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala. Walhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.